My father was a miner until he was retired. My grandfather was a miner until he retired there. A little bit of our history of the area. It's really rich in developing from the iron ore days of the early 1900s when iron ore was discovered, which led to an influx of a need of workers in the area. Many of those first-time workers were first-generation immigrants, kind of a melting pot of nationalities, language, and it wasn't a requirement to have English as a mastery in order to work in the mines there. It was a time of prosperity in our community. It was a time where you had new jobs, new businesses created to support the industry of the mines and the families in the area. But then we went through some tough times. As the mines started to close, the last pockets of ore, you know, one by one the mines closed and the sound of the diesel and the thunder of the trucks and the earth movers went away. And it was during this time that our community struggled for a new identity. What do we replace the good days, the great days of the mines? How do we replace those jobs?
Well, when the mines pulled out of this area, the economy dropped very fast, and the pits filled up with water, and vegetation grew over it, and the businesses in Main Street of Crosby closed, and what it turned into was a retirement community. We have beautiful lakes and trees and woods in the area and good hunting. And what it became is a retirement area where people came back and moved in as retirement. And so we had a small amount of tourism in the area. The decision for the city of Cuyuna or the city to get into a pump track was quite an involved process. We wanted a silent sport. And we had scuba diving out here and we had fishing, and the bikes would kind of fit in here. And we decided that a pump track would probably get our kids off the couch and on these games and get them out and exercise and learn how to enjoy nature and get out and do some exercise.
Cool. You know, I just watch what kids do, and any place you see a pile of dirt, you see kids jumping over the pile of dirt with their bikes. And I thought, let's put in some kind of a bike park. Piles of dirt don't cost much. That idea kind of resonated with the city, and so it was time to start adding a little bit of structure to the idea. So a friend of mine, Peter Gustafson, is an accomplished BMX racer, and he can make a bicycle do things that most people can't. And so I thought I'd check with Peter and see if he had any ideas. And when I approached him with the idea, he said, well, make a pump track. Well, that's the first I'd ever heard of a pump track. So I asked him what it was, and the more he described it, it's only really a cool deal. And something you could do in real simple form without putting a lot of money into it. And so I brought that back to the city council as an idea, and it seemed to be something that had some possibilities. It would be something that we could do without maybe a lot of expense, and then it'd be something that if it turned out that it didn't work, we could easily dismantle it and return the property back to its original structure.
I've ridden hundreds of pump tracks across the U.S. And what really excites me about the pump track in Cuyuna is an opportunity to get people into mountain biking that have never been mountain biking before, get people into cycling that's never been into cycling before. The mountain bike trails are already drawing people from across the U.S. We've had people from Germany, South Africa, people from South America. So it's not only would it draw people from the local community, but it would also draw people from countywide and also statewide. There's plenty of people that drive up from the Twin Cities on a weekly basis to ride the mountain bike trails. And adding another feature like a pump track is only going to draw more and more people from outside areas, from Duluth, from Bemidji.
All of a sudden it became apparent that there was enough interest, then rather than just build a pump track with some piles of dirt at the lowest cost possible, and it would be whatever it is, to turn it into a first-class, world-class pump track. And with amenities, buildings, water, restroom facilities, have it professionally designed by Lee McCormick. I made those contacts a long time ago with McCormick. That evolved into having not a little pump track for kids to play on, but a big professionally designed pump track, something that would attract people from all over, and it'd be something that really worked.
In the city of Cuyuna here, we had a restaurant and bar that was in business for 32 years and had to close because of financial reasons, and it was turned over to a bank. And last night at the council meeting, a person stepped forward and said they're going to take a chance and purchase the restaurant and bar because of this pump track and what they've heard, how the bikers have helped the area in this downtown of Crosby and Ironton. So that's why now we're going to go first class on everything to make it one of the best trails in the United States. And I think that's our goal now, is having a Class A pump track that everybody in the area can be proud of.
In my real job, I work with low-income rural communities dealing with drinking water, wastewater infrastructure, and as such, it's really kind of a community development process. Started in on the project really when the city was kind of discussing it during council meetings as I sat on for infrastructure projects. They had brought up pump track, park, and whatnot, and I said, I think we can get some grant dollars for that. Let me work on that, and I think that was, what, nine to 10 months ago, and really here we are now. In terms of the project being in the city of Cuyuna, it is in the city limits of Cuyuna. It's slated to be developed on approximately seven acre parcel. Types of funding that we've secured, we've got $15,000 secured from the Hallett Trust Foundation, $1,500 from Minnesota Power Foundation. The city has currently provided $3,500, which totals $20,000. Our overall estimated cost of the project is roughly $75,000. We don't want it to just be a pump track. We want it to be an epic pump track. We want it to be nationally recognized. We want people to come from the entire nation here to ride our trails, our pump track, use our trailhead here. Because if someone comes from out of state, we want them to come to Cuyuna. But we also want them to go up to Duluth or go up to Grand Marais and use those trails and really kind of benefit from what other organizations and partnerships those organizations have built. We can do this, we can make this nationally recognized and use Cuyuna as a focal point to build other single track trails and further pump track parks for youth development and furthering the sport along.
As I'm sitting here, I'm sitting right on one of the expert trails. When I'm looking at this trail, and I think back when the plan was first adopted in 1995 to put mountain bike trails in the rec area, I just could not even in my mind imagine the magnitude of what was going to be done eventually. What we have today goes so far beyond anything I could imagine. And we have all of this, and now to think about a world-class pump track 1 mile north of here is unbelievable. For the kids that grow up in this area, that call this home, it's an unbelievable resource. And for all the young people that come with their families to ride here, it can provide for a complete experience. This is one of the greatest things we can do to get young people active, out, and enjoy.
I personally live in the city of Cuyuna, and my father moved to the Cuyuna Iron Range in 1911, the same year that Cuyuna was incorporated. And my dad grew into to be quite a mining company. And the Manuel Pit is named after my grandfather. And the Yawkey Pit is named after, people don't know, but it's a Thomas Yawkey that owned the Boston Red Sox. And my dad did the mining for Thomas at the Yawkey mine. And there's other mines in the area that I've become very familiar with me. When I go biking out there, like the Virginia mine is named after my grandmother, I get kind of tight. I talk about this. So I think that this is probably one of the nicest things that's ever happened in the Cuyuna Range, is that we're getting some activity. And I personally enjoy it because every biker that I've talked to enjoys the area.
We have new people, but we have the same vision. We have the same opportunities. We have the same land. We have the same overburden, the ore. We have the same tailings being used in a different way to advance the prosperity and bring new life to our communities. We have a passion for our communities. We seem to have a passion to throw ourselves behind efforts that make our community better. Today, we're wielding pick and shovel, carving our mining history into our new identity, mountain bike trails, family outings. And I perceive that Imba has the same type of passion. So our question would be, or actually an invitation, that you come and share your passion with ours and watch the story continue to grow. You won't be disappointed with the outcome.